Do you just say no to caffeine?
No, don't use it. Caffeine, tannin. I always prescribe, a lot of people shout me on this, I always prescribe all my clients liquor. But don't drink tea and coffee. So, because it is going to cause you a lot of problems. So, occasionally it is fine. In this cold environment, sometimes when it is very cold, you are drinking caffeine to increase your blood pressure, it is fine. But when it is very hot and you are drinking it, above 60, 70, it is of no use. Because if you don't get caffeine, you are going into the same withdrawal syndrome as an alcoholic does, as a drug addict does. Only because it is an acceptable, not an acceptable evil. You know, we socially, we don't outcast this. We think it is good. I always, you take out the statistics, coffee shops make 10 times more business than liquor shops. Taken all bars and liquor shops together. Only coffee shops. Why? Because it is addiction. But we don't think of it in that way. We think it is good. Tea, coffee, don't drink. These are 200, 100, 150 year old drinks. Liquor has been going on from ages. And when I talk about liquor, you know, it is used in all aspects. We use it in cooking. Italians use it in cooking, in drinking. So it has got proven benefits if you are using it in the same quantity as you are using coffee. A cup of coffee and a cup of liquor, liquor will give you more benefits than coffee. 10 times more benefit.
Mm. Alright.
Yeah. So now, yeah.
So you were talking a little bit about the history of, you know, where you're from, where your people are from, the food growing history of where you live. So do you take that into, when you meet with someone, are you also looking at like where they live, the environment that they live in, and the seasons, as far as that would change the kind of diet that maybe somebody would eat than someone who's living in, you know, the tropics?
See, for me, as I said, because I study all this, I try to remain to the fundamental sense measures. So I give this to everyone. This history is required for people to understand why certain things are required and why certain things are not required. When you make a sudden change in your diet, you know, when you are completely non-vegetarian and suddenly try to go vegan, for whatever reasons it is, that is not, I'm not talking about it. But if you're suffering and you're thinking, oh man, you know, I'm suffering from this, and whatever reasons you have become, you're not even able to execute it, then you should think. This linearity should, Ayurveda is not about it. Ayurveda doesn't tell you that only eat vegetarian, only eat green food. It never tells you, it is never mentioned in any text. Either not directly. Certainly if it is mentioned, then maybe I am not that intelligent to decipher it, but I have not seen it. It gives everything. So what does it tell you? That these are properties, these are things. Nothing is medicine and nothing is beyond poison. Everything is a medicine. So don't make this choice. You cannot control factors. You cannot say that I am not good, that GMO crops are bad, this are, yes, you are still going to have it. In some way or the other, pesticides are going into your body. Chemtrails go, they are going into your system. You cannot avoid it. So you have to adapt. And you can only adapt by this awareness. Eat on time, sleep on time, let your organs work the optimum. Because when you are doing this, it is just a gimmick. When you are supporting the organic industry, it is good to support. But everything, it is mimic, it is like a marketing. We always talk about this Coca-Cola ad, you know, when I gave that in earlier times. You see, we retain the image 1/3 of a time with our eyes. So after every half frame, one Coca-Cola was put, and when you see the movie, and in the break, advertently people used to go and drink Coca-Cola. You never used to see it, but it was registered on your brain. Same thing, this kind of world marketing, everything occurs. Once you create a system, you create a need, and then it is given to you in a packaged form. You see, so many of labels, you go vegan, gluten-free wheat, gluten-free meat. Because you have created the need. So it is being supported to you. Is it required? We don't know. Maybe some people with cephalic diseases may say no, gluten is free. But as I told, change the wheat. In the US, what wheat is used is substandard. Try wheat from another country. You use red wheat, we use brown wheat. It's very different. Even wheats found in India are different. There are so many varieties of it. As I say, if you start eating every variety of apple one day, you will cross 70 and the varieties won't end. There are so many varieties of apple. You cannot say apple is good, apple is bad. Some apple is poisonous, some apple is good, some apple is bad. In that time space constant. But you cannot go and catalog everything and say, oh no, this is good, this is bad. You will die of confusion. So you can only do what you can do. You can create a system which can digest anything. Tomorrow I throw you in a desert, or it throw you in winds or it throw you in mountains, you must be able to survive. That's what Ayurveda tells you. If you are true to your system, you can survive and transcend anything. Rest, all these things are used to make your experience good, so that you can enjoy your food and not be guilty about it and not feel bad about it. Some introspection is given so that it leads you away from confusions. Why am I suffering from so many things? I am not understanding anything. So many people who are suffering from chronic disorders are doing so many things. They are doing yoga, they are doing some mantra chikitsa, they are doing some shamanism, they are doing this juicing, then between they will do some colon cleansing, then between they will do something. Again, they are, modern medicines are also going on. And they will create a placebo that, okay, I am feeling better. But you are spending so much time in doing treatments of which you have got no head or tail whether it is working or not working. There is no system to understand it. But because a conscious mind is not thinking in that way, we do not understand it. So do only one thing. Your system is not bad. It is not that because it is coming from India, it is Ayurveda, that is spiritual, it is good. This is also Ayurveda. You have to just study your history. Where you have come from. Where the farming started. How it started here. What was it? America was like a vast land with only few Indians here, there, you know, doing their own community farming. Lot of the lands was unaccounted, still is unaccounted for. So you have to understand how it started, what were the conditions. Here you don't have monsoons. Most of the waters what you get are from glacial valleys. Everything from Yosemite to everything is a glacial valley. So if glaciers have resided, water is there, water. Sometimes you get what is the Mexican monsoon. Then how can you do basti? We have perfect 3 months monsoon. So you have to understand when to use it. Is it required by you? As before this lecture, I gave about the questions of constipation. You know, sit in good postures. Now we have this, sit in good posture. See that your defecation is happening within 6 seconds. The moment you go, it should go out, it should be out. You should not be in there, you know, reading magazines, reading newspapers, chatting. And then you go out 1 hour, 2 hours, which a lot of people do. That simple thing will give you colon cancers, will give you ovarian cancers, will give you breast cancers. Because you are not throwing it out. So when you lean in yoga, you learn this squatting position, what you call as pashasana. In your ashtanga it is there. Learn it well. So you know, these things are very important of how exactly you are in tune with your anatomy. How each organ is working for each other. No organ is working on its own. If liver gets swelling, the heart has to work more. If the kidney gets swelling, the heart and the liver. Therefore, it is called as a peritoneal pressure. If everything goes, you get water in your stomach. So it is there.
What about like herbal teas, things like that? Like fennel tea, cinnamon tea?
Again, why are you using it? Like I said, if I have to kill someone and not get caught, I'll give him fennel every day on empty stomach. His tissues will go and he'll die within 1 month, 2 months. Nothing else, just tell him be on fennel. Because it will destroy it, therefore it is used in meat, right? So think before drinking any tea. If you are on blood thinners and you are taking garlic, if I hit you in the stomach, you might get internal bleeding and die of low blood pressure. You won't even know. It is an internal hemorrhage. You are eating so many things, you are popping so many pills, vitamins, this, nettle tea, this, and then somebody tells you, don't do that. Stick to one thing. If you are finding one tea beneficial for you, only drink that. I don't know why you will drink it, what
no, time is no, I don't drink fennel tea, but I drink cinnamon, I crave it all the time.
Yes.
So I drink cinnamon, so therefore
that should
drink
be there.
Cinnamon in,
see, it doesn't make a difference. You should understand why is it helping you. If it's just taking it like it is fine. I'm not saying that you're putting cinnamon in milk, you're drinking it, it's good. But some people go on taking certain herbal teas because I'm talking in a broader context. I'm not talking in your context. So that should be taken into account. If you are taking certain things for certain specific reasons, then understand it's wrong and don't problem. There are very few things in the world which are like not going to cause you problems. But concoctions when you make like teas, they are like strong potent medicines. When I eat it, it is not, you know, it goes off. So powders and all are fine. When you make concoctions, there are serious differences. The moment you drink cinnamon tea, you will perspire. It's a direct effect. While you are drinking tea, you will perspire. But you eat cinnamon, it is not going to happen. You take cinnamon powder, you won't perspire. You might perspire after 1 hour, 2 hours, something. Moment you drink cinnamon tree, you will perspire. So what it is telling you? It is acting on your bioreceptors. So it is a medicine. And when you're putting it as a powder, it is a food. These are simple changes. So when you take it for a long period of time, anything, any herb you take, it doesn't matter if it is an Amazonian herb or a Transylvanian herb, Siberian herb, Indian herb, you know, all plants, all belong to certain genus and species. We get the, what is it, we get the peppermint, it might be some Coleus ambonicus variety indica, here you will get Coleus ambonicus variety americana. It will be the same genus. The species are different. Adaptation is different. Taxonomy tells us. It belong to the same family, Amliferi, you know, same thing. So it is not different. It's not that this is coming from India, so it is more good. Or this is coming from America, so it is not. You have to see how it is, in what condition it is more. Your homegrown cinnamon might be 10 times better than what you can get from India if you grow it in the right condition. The whole thing, you have to know what you are trying to look from it. So therefore, instead of looking into 10, 20, 30, 40 spices, herbs which you have got no head and tail, how they are working in your body, do something about spices which you know, which your ancestors have been used over a period of time, parsley or whatever it is, you know, see how they are. Go back to your traditional meats, whatever foods you have been, if you are a German descent, because here it is an amalgamation of lot of cultures, it is not like everyone is from one place. So see what have you been eating. Suddenly when you come to a different country, suddenly don't change your food patterns, because your children will still be adapted to that. If you are into a mixed ethnicity, like father is from different ethnicity, mother is from different, then think in those terms. What were your common grounds? What you used to eat? And if you do that very well, it's fine. Suddenly in Scandinavia, Denmark, people started becoming vegan. SLE, autoimmune disorder started rising. They started using these hand sanitizers, autoimmune disorder started. Now, why would we start in one of the best countries in the world like Denmark? And so you could think. When suddenly you adapt something because you think it is good, it might not be good for you. It might be good in that time space quantum. If I suddenly go and start eating salami pork, in my, it might not be good for me. I might not be able to digest it because my system has been developed to digest certain things as per my ancestry. I stay near the coast, maybe I can digest fish much better. So when I go to different parts of Maharashtra, if they eat something, I feel so spicy, they can eat like tons of it like that. They laugh at me, oh, you can't even eat this much, you are from the city. It's not about the city, I can't digest it. If I get that same guy in my place, he won't be able to digest my food. So that adaptability level will never die, which however cosmopolitan you become, wherever you go, because it transcends the gene level, that gene code never goes. So once you understand this, you use these methods, you know, follow your time pattern, which basic time pattern I have given you, whatever you eat, you will be fine. Apart from that, if you have some diseases, disorder, of course, consult someone who is knowledgeable and work with it.
I drink a lot of water, and I find that like I try to sit throughout the day, and then I'll realize it's been a long time since I drank water, and then I'm gonna be eating in a little while, so I'll, you know, drink like a whole glass in one gulp. And so, would you just go over? I understand sip by sip, but how do we know how much is enough?
Because you have confused your body, you have confused your brain by making it drink water. It is not required. First thing, why are you drinking water? There must be some reason why you started. You might not know it now, but there must be some reason why you started. So forget that reason. You are not required. You are only required to drink water when it is required. Your body will tell you.
Okay.
The moment you are hungry and you sip water, you are causing yourself more problems. You will become more hyper.
Okay.
You know, you'll get anger bouts very quickly, slowly but surely. Hair starts becoming, you know, graying very quickly, premature graying. Water causes you lots of problems if it is not digested. If it is digested, you are one of the lucky person who has digested up till now fine. Secondly, stop using metal. You know, you get nowadays hardened clay or hardened glass bottles. Use that. Don't use these BPA-free bottles if you are carrying with you, if you are a water drinker. Third thing, I always tell that, you know, only use copper vessels when it is warm. I see a lot of people installing copper tanks in water. Don't do that. It will cause you infertility. You know, IUDs are made up of copper. But a lot of people drink out of copper. Unnecessary. Not required. On hot condition, it is fine. Cold conditions not required. So use these metals also intellectually. Drink milk in silver. You have silverware. A lot of people earlier used to have silverware. There was a reason behind it. It was a disinfectant. When you put meat in silver, anything in silver, you do not get the problems. So everything was of silver. Became a status symbol then, okay, fine. So if you have it in your house, don't keep it for show. Use some of it. It is difficult to maintain, but use it. There is nothing that light cannot clean. Clean it with light. So, you know, if you do this very well, you will get maximum benefit from whatever food you can eat. No need to find different exotic food and burn your pockets or break a bank. The same food what you can get from your market, you can make exotic things from it if you use it logically. So same with water. Drink, if you throw this habit, drink early morning, get up, drink this much of water, then only drink water. If you don't have it, you have water, feel thirsty, go somewhere and drink water, is fine. When you have water with you, you'll always go on drinking. It is a habit like coffee. You have coffee, you're going on sipping. It will cause you problem. Then your hunger will die down, you won't feel hungry, you won't feel like eating food. Sometimes the hunger pangs will come here and there. Yeah. You say, okay, fine, I'll drink water. So, you know, that thing, sometimes we feel we are doing a lot of heavy work, so we drink, require water. Don't drink. Wait. Therefore, in yoga also, it says, the moment you do a workout, don't drink water. Wait. But a lot of people go out and drink water. So, wait.
If you sweat a lot, should you replace?
It will make your swelling even more worse. It might throw it out. So, you have to correct it. You have to reduce salts. The moment you reduce salts, the water will go. Because your kidneys are not working. The moment you swell, means your kidneys are under pressure. A lot of women swell before menses. Kidneys are under pressure.
I mean, it's very hot out. Like, you're in 100 degrees and you're sweating.
You're saying sweating. I heard swelling. Sorry.
Sorry.
So, if you're sweating, you're feeling thirsty drink. But always think, as I said, sip by sip, you have to drink. Mix the saliva. Saliva is the best thing that God has given you. We waste it a lot. In yoga also, when we do these practices, we do it for the saliva. So whenever you do breathing practices, the saliva comes, we do it so that we can swallow it. It is the best immunomodulator world as nature has given you. But we don't use it. So use it. You'll see your inflammation goes down. When you're sweating a lot, fine, you know, you can drink a little bit more. But drink it at intervals. Don't go on sipping it. You drink something, you eat. Again, you feel like you will get it completely. Your throat will become dry, your lips will become dry, tongue will become dry. You will feel like water. When you feel like water, drink it. Just don't drink because, oh, it's hot, I need to drink water.
Mm-hmm.
Don't do it. Your body will tell you. Mm-hmm. It has got a lot of water to digest. You are 70-80% water. It will use it. If you feed it more, it will clog it. See, again I said, why are you using it is important. Some people use lemon and water because they want to lose weight, or some people think it is a good cleansing agent. So if you're using it in yogis, people use it in yogi, we sometimes use it so their body can become light, it cleanses. But as I said, that you use it only if there is a certain requirement for it. Unnecessary requirement, you know, I see a lot of time people come from the heat and there is lemon and water. It's fine, you can use it. You know, you've done a lot of hard work, you come out, you want to replenish yourself. Or you feel that early in the morning, most of the times you're constipated, sometimes lemon water, it is fine. So for something it is fine. Unnecessary using it is not a good thing, because it can make your blood acidic also.
Mm. What about fermentation? The fermentation of foods?
I told you about it. You know, that's the main basis of disorders. Because earlier times in here, same thing was happening. When first in England it was happening, where all most people came from. That they didn't, 6 months there was nothing, only snow. So they used to take whatever they used to get, put water and put it underground. And one used to ferment, after 7 days they used to create this bread.
Yes.
So it is going to cause you colon problems. But that time there was nothing to do. Therefore this entire entourage colonization started for the very reason to find these spices, to find these things so that they get cured of these things.
But what you said, wine,
that is different, because what you're doing, one is in one fermentation process you're making something not amiable, you know, it is something which is bad, which is rotted, you're rotting something.
Yes.
And in that kind of fermentation you're creating something, you're creating an appetizer. So it is different, same process but different. Here you're putting water to rot the bread so that you can create a bread. Here in fermenting, you are trying to create something, you are trying to mix the juices and create something which can stay lifelong. Because earlier times it was always required that, you know, some things can remain lifelong because you did not have the resources. So get the grapes, get the wines and create the wine. Because grapes are not available all year long. If you see in the olden ships, what they used to get the pork, they used to cut it, they used to put vinegar, they used to pickle it and give it to the sailors. Why? Because pickled items do not spoil quickly. So the pickling was done. So the sausage pickles, this pickles, this everything you see in the olden times. If you see the old ships which are shipwrecks, the first thing you find is these pickles. So that is the reason. So it was done for sustainability. Because they had nothing to eat to tide through the cold winter. What would they eat? So those things you have to understand.
Is there anything, this is a lot of being so important, is there anything that actually helps increase saliva production?
Increase what?
Saliva production.
Yogic practices. But that you have to learn from the master. If you do the yogic practices well, then the saliva increases. In fact, if your pranayama is going well, your saliva should increase.
No. I mean, it has. I have Sjogren's. It's a autoimmune that affects my saliva and tears. And it's gotten much, much better with yoga. I don't have to use... the only thing beyond yoga practice, all I do now with it is... and I don't know that it helps or not, but I do oil pulling.
It's fine. It's like it's not something bad unless and until you're not swallowing it.
No, it's fine.
You know, like... Those are the things which were given to strengthen the teeth, so you can use it. It's like those things are very external, it doesn't make much of a difference. Yeah.
You mentioned to eat fenugreek in the morning, just a few seeds.
Maybe you can just take 1 teaspoon in the, soak it in the water, and next teaspoon, and just that's it, not much.
Okay.
Always good for women, you know. So. If you eat it regularly, it will always do a lot of wonders. I always call it as a wonder herb. Simple seeds. But what happens, because these spices are so common, people tend to overlook them. They feel that if they are diseased, they require something which is expensive. But what this spice is going to do? It's not like that. There are wonders of spices, you know, which you can do many things. And you don't even require any prescription for it. Main thing. So, like, why not use it?
Can you repeat what was the
fenugreek?